हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर टू गोइंग डिस्कस ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ एब्सोल्यूट वेलोसिटी ऑफ आयंस एंड आयोनिक कंडक्टेंस. फ्रेंड्स, बिफोर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द डेरिवेशन ऑफ एब्सोल्यूट वेलोसिटी ऑफ आयंस एंड आयोनिक कंडक्टेंस, वी शुड अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द आयोनिक कंडक्टेंस एंड व्हिच फैक्टर्स आर अफेक्टेड और ऑन व्हिच फैक्टर द आयोनिक कंडक्टेंस आर डिपेंड. द फर्स्ट आयोनिक कंडक्टेंस, वी शुड अंडरस्टैंड द इलेक्ट्रोलाइट विच वी हैव टू कंसिडर फॉर द कैरिंग द इलेक्ट्रिक करंट फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू द अनदर प्लेस एंड बाय यूजिंग दैट मूविंग सिचुएशन ऑफ द करंट वी शुड प्रोसीड द नंबर ऑफ वर्क इन द केमिस्ट्री लैबोरेटरी वर्क. सो फ्रेंड्स, आयोनिक मोबिलिटी इज कंप्लीटली डिपेंड ऑन द नंबर ऑफ आयंस, नेचर ऑफ आयंस and what is the capacity of ions to carry the current. How much current can be carried by the ions is determined by their mobility, or it's known as the transport number. And ion is moved from one place to the another place is also depend on how much potential gradient we have applied on that particular electrolytic solution. So friend, absolute velocity is also one of the part in which we have to measure the exact speed of the ions. On the basis of if we want to study the absolute velocity, we should understand how much pressure is applied, how much temperature is applied, how the nature of ion, how the nature of electrolyte, whether the electrolyte is weak, whether the electrolyte is strong. On those of the basis, as well as how much potential drop we have to apply on this. Same thing is also very important, that is the ion is positive or negative. Those the factors which are responsible for the velocity of ion and also the current carrying capacity of the ions. So friend, let's start to determine how much ions can having a capacity to carry the current and how we find out the mobility of the ions. Therefore, I just write down here the derivation, but step by step we should be discuss on this. So friends, before going to start the derivation, we should understand the nature of electrolyte. Whatever the electrolyte we take for the mobility of the current or study of the current, that electrolyte I have represent in the form of general reaction, that is AXBY, which gives X A raised to Z plus plus y b raised to z minus. So friend, what is the x, what is the z plus? Z plus is the charge. Of course, the positive charge is it is a positive cation, and this one is the negative cation, and the charge shown on this is the z plus and z minus. X is the number of ions. Yes, it is a stoichiometry, means how many ions is present in that electrolyte. Suppose here I am take one of the example of sodium carbonate, Na2CO3, means how much positive ions is there. Of course, there is a two positive ions, okay, and one negative ions. Therefore, Na2, this stoichiometry for sodium is 2, stoichiometry for carbonate is 1, and Z plus is 1, and here Z minus is 2. Of course, this is the ion determination. Okay, I hope you understand this example. Now, when electrolyte is dissociate in the form of X alpha, Y alpha. What is the meaning of alpha? Alpha is the degree of dissociation. We had already discussed in our previous video regarding to, I thought, in weak electrolyte. Yeah. And if number of A ions dissociate alpha, therefore what happen, whatever the A and B salt I have take, that is denoted by 1 minus alpha, okay, denoted by 1 minus alpha. Suppose friends, if our electrolyte is 1, we have to consider, then whatever 1 minus alpha and number of ions is dissociate. This is the proper dissociation pattern of the electrolyte. Now we proceed for the next one, that is the N plus. number of cations can contains this much, that is the number of cations, alpha is the degree of dissociation, and of course capital N for the Avogadro's number. And when the number of ions and their denotations we understand, that time we determine the current. How to find out the current? The current is I is equal to N plus, means this one, Z plus E, E is the potential drop, V plus plus V minus by D. What is the meaning of D? What is the meaning of V plus and V minus? Then student, be listen carefully. If you can't listen, you are not understand the terms. V plus is the velocity of cations. V minus is the velocity of anion. D is the distance. When we consider any electrolyte and we want to study the current carrying capacity of the ions or how much current carrying by the ions, that time we put two electrode, okay, and in between two electrode how much ions are comes or how much electrolyte which are come in that particular area, that area, that electrolyte is keep apart from each other by using a proper distance, and that distance is nothing but D, and how much amount of electrolyte is come under that cross sectional area of the two electrode, that area can contain how much ions, the current carrying capacity is depend only on that ions. So friends, D is the distance between two electrolytes. Then Z plus is the Z plus is the positive charge, N plus is the positive charge related to the ions, and how much terms are involved in that, of course that is X, number of ions for the positive cation, alpha is the degree of dissociation, and N is the Avogadro's number. When friends we know the N plus, then I just substitute the value of N plus into this equation in the form of X alpha N. So friend, when I substituted this value, then I get X alpha N, Z plus E, V plus V minus, and divided by D. Then N E means Avogadro's number into E is nothing but the F. F means, of course, it is the Faraday's constant and is nothing but the 1. When we multiply Avogadro's number by, to the E, we will be get the Faraday's, and Faraday's we have considered in this equation is 1. And when I substitute this value, I get the new equation regarding to that. I just rough here N E, and I substitute the value of Fe, that is F, and I get this equation. So friend, X alpha Z, suppose if we consider the current regarding to the particular electrolyte, that is the X alpha Z V plus plus V minus by D. In this case I am not consider F because F having a value 1 by D is equal to, suppose now we consider any one of the electrolyte, 1 mole of the electrolyte corresponding to that, and when we find out volume per equivalent, that time we get 1000 upon C. Volume per equivalent is nothing but the 1000 upon C, and volume per mole is nothing but 1000 into X into Z plus. Remember, volume per equivalent and this one is volume per mole. In this case, we consider the number of moles which are present in the positive cations as well as the concentration, and therefore we get the new equation, that is 1000 into X into Z plus by C. So friend, when we compare both of the equation, I get here A for the area. Of course, I have recently discussed with you the cross sectional area, and D is the distance. Yeah. The electrode are apart from each other, that is the distance, D is the distance, is equal to 1000 into X into Z plus by C. This one means how much ions are present in that electrolyte, which is determined by the AD. Now I just rearrange this equation, A into C, 1000 is come here, means AC by 1000 is equal to XZ plus by D. This is just rearrangement, okay. And after rearranging this, we come toward the another point, that is the conductance. So friends, we want to determine the conductance of the electrolyte, and therefore, as we know, L is equal to LS into A by D. This equation we had studied in our previous video. And friends, conductance determination is very important thing because we want to find out the mobility and current carrying capacity of the ions. Now let's start the discussion on conductance. L is equal to LS into A by D. Okay, then LS into A by D. LS is the specific conductance, A is the cross sectional area, and D is the distance between two electrodes which are kept apart from the each other in the electrolyte. Okay, if you remember that specific conductance is nothing but the C into lambda into thousand. If you are not remember, you just remember the equivalent conductance equation, that is the lambda is equal to, what is that equation? Yeah, thousand into LS by C. If I am not wrong, that this equation is correct one. And if you rearrange this, you will be get LS is equal to C into lambda by 1000. Okay, I hope you understand. Now, I just find out the value of LS also. And when you find out the value of specific conductance, you just substitute the value of specific conductance into the above equation. You will get conductance is equal to C into lambda by 1000 into A by D. So friend, after rearranging this equation, we get that AC by 1000 into lambda by D. So friend, AC by 1000 we have already calculated here. AC by 1000 is nothing but X into Z plus by D. As a substitute here value, X into Z plus by D into lambda by D. Okay, so friend, rearranging this, because all term are multiplication, in the form of multiplication, I get here X into Z plus into lambda by D square. Okay, and this is the value of conductance regarding to the electrolyte. Means what? The conductance of the electrolyte is depend on the X, means number of moles which are present in the electrolyte. Which moles? Of course, that is the cation, and lambda is the equivalent conductance. The conductance is also related to the equivalent conductance and distance. Okay, the conductance is related to those of the terms. And when we apply the Ohm's law for the electrolyte, what is the Ohm's law? E by R is equal to E L, and E L is nothing but the, yeah, it is nothing but the current, which is denoted by the R. And friends, E L is equal to R, I just take here, then keep out the E outside the bracket and substitute the value of L which we have find out here. Okay, I just substitute here X into Z plus into lambda by D square, the value of L. And friends, in previous equation, we have already find out the value of I, that is the X alpha F Z plus V plus V minus by D. Just substitute, and after rearranging or comparing the equation, you will be get that here is a D square, here is a D. Therefore, 1D is cancelled out. We will get E by D X Z plus, of course, because this equation we are evaluated only for the cation, and therefore we take here Z plus. Friends, if you have any question regarding to this, why we are not find out the same derivation for anion, you just take instead of Z plus, Z minus, you will be get the derivation for the anions, because both the ions are responsible to carry the current. Okay, now let's start. Then E by D J X Z plus lambda is equal to alpha F X Z plus V minus. Friends, when this term goes toward this side, it will be get cancel, and we get E by D lambda. Then what is remaining here? Of course, alpha into F V plus V minus, and this term E by D, this term we will be replaced by E dash. Okay, E dash lambda is equal to alpha into F V plus V minus, and when we rearrange this equation again, I am right here. I hope it visible for you. E dash lambda is equal to alpha into F V plus plus V minus, of course those are the velocities, and when we rearrange this term, keep alpha lambda outside, V plus by E drop E dash plus V minus by E dash, those are the terms we will be getting. Friends, this is the starting equation of this topic of absolute velocity of ions and ionic conductance, and in our next video we will be discuss how this starting equation is used to determine the mobility of ions and to find out the transport number. Thank you very much.